Mia, what are you doing? Yeah, that sounds fun. Terrific. Oh, welcome back, historians. Today, we're taking a look at the Maya in Central America. And one of the coolest things about the Maya was their amazing system of math. Mia is actually working on something related to their math right now. Did you know that while modern math is based on tens, like 10, 20, 30, the Maya counted in 20s? That's right. Their entire numbering system was based on the number 20. So let's talk about how they used their math skills. Picture bustling cities with towering pyramids, busy markets, and wide-open plazas. In this incredible place, the Maya were making huge discoveries in mathematics and using them in ways that were ahead of their time. Their numbering system had three simple symbols: a shell for zero, a dot for one, and a bar for five. And with these three symbols, they could write any number. Let's give it a try together. How would the Maya write the number 13 using only dots and bars? Pause to respond. Did you come up with this? Nice effort. This Maya math is pretty cool. Mia had a great idea. As we explore the Maya today, let's use their math to provide a few clues. You may want to keep this Maya math chart handy. It's in the PDF, or you can jot it down on paper. So pause here if you need to. Today, as we solve Maya math problems, we will also describe the primary achievements of the Maya and explain Maya culture. And as we check out the Maya, think also about this question. Why do you think their math system is based on 20? The answer will be revealed at the end. Are you ready to solve this math mystery, historians? About 4,000 years ago, something amazing started happening in Mesoamerica. The Mayan culture began to grow. But guess what? It grew really, really slowly. In fact, the Maya civilization developed slowly enough that the Olmecs are usually called the first big civilization in the Americas. Yeah, even though they started their civilization about 600 years after the Maya, as you can see on the timeline. During this period of slow growth, what do you think Mayan life was like? During those centuries of development, the Maya lived mostly in small villages and farmed. Fast forward more than 2,000 years to 250 CE, and we find the Maya in their classic period. This was when they built awesome things like giant pyramids and temples. Imagine huge stone buildings with awesome carvings, cool statues of their gods and leaders. The Maya are famous for both. They didn't just stop there. They built big cities with roads, bridges, places to play games, and big open squares. They even made beautiful sculptures, pottery, and shiny jewelry, especially for special occasions. Wait a second. Where do you think the Maya got some of these awesome ideas? Yeah, they used many ideas from the Olmecs. Now get ready for this. The Maya were like ancient scientists. They used their awesome math skills to create a super detailed calendar system that could track the sun, moon, and planets. So here is our first question using Maya math. How many months did the Maya have in their calendar? Use the symbol shown here to determine the answer. Pause to check the Maya math table and to respond. Yeah, the Maya calendar had 18 months, and each month had 20 days. Plus, they had 5 days at the end of the year that they considered really unlucky. During this time, they believed the boundaries between the real world and the supernatural blurred, which would allow evil spirits to interact with the living. Spooky, huh? It's truly amazing how accurate their calendar was. I mean, people in other parts of the world had similar calendars, but the Maya had no contact with them at all. Why do you think people who lived so far apart ended up making similar things? Maybe it's because all people, no matter where they are, often have the same big questions. They all want to understand the world better. Or maybe they were just curious. You already know, the Maya were super smart with numbers. They were one of the first civilizations to use the number zero, which is really important for math today. The Maya were also amazing farmers. They came up with smart ways to grow more food, like building special watering systems and shaping hillsides to stop the dirt from washing away. These ideas were so good that later, other people started using them too. Oh, how about that question I asked earlier? Why do you think the Maya math system is based on 20? Have you been able to put your finger on the answer yet? In Maya society, just like in other civilizations we've studied, there were different levels. This symbol lets you know how many tiers the Maya had in their social structure. Yeah, 3. You're getting the hang of this Mayan math. At the very top were the rulers, nobles, and priests. They lived in huge, fancy houses and had a lot of power. Then there were the common people, like the farmers who grew the food, the craft makers who made all sorts of neat things, and the traders who traveled to sell stuff. They were the backbone of Mayan society. Enslaved people were at the bottom of the Mayan society. They were usually people who were captured in wars or owed big debts. And they were used for big projects, like building those amazing temples and palaces found in ancient Maya cities. So think back. Did some of the civilizations we've studied previously have slavery? Yeah, slavery was present in most of the places we've studied, like ancient Rome and Egypt. But it's totally unacceptable today. Just like their social structure had different levels, the Maya way of life was really detailed and interesting. Religion was a big part of their everyday life, influencing everything they did and how they saw the world. But do you think the Maya were monotheistic? Or do you think they worshipped many gods? Circle the answer on your PDF that you think is correct. The Maya believed in many gods and goddesses, each with their own special job. Priests were like the religious superstars, doing all kinds of ceremonies and rituals, and making offerings to make the gods happy. Pause here for a second and think. What kind of offerings do you think the Maya made to please the gods? The Maya offered valuable things like jewels, animals, even people, to get good luck from the gods in farming, health, and battles. It was all part of their religious ceremonies. So who was offered to the gods? Mostly, it was prisoners from other tribes and civilizations. Like slavery, it's unacceptable in today's world, but for the Maya, it was part of their culture and how they understood their world. Even though Mayan culture remained strong in Central America for many more years, the last writing found by historians is dated 909. So what happened? Historians believe droughts and maybe sickness led to starvation, ending the Maya civilization's time as a Mesoamerican powerhouse. However, their influence on other societies in the region, even today, is obvious. Okay, you've waited long enough. Let's see if you've been able to toe the line and come up with an answer to this question. Why do you think the Maya math system is based on 20? Historians generally agree that the Mayan math system is based on 20 because that's how many fingers and toes most people have. Yeah, think about it. Have you ever used your fingers to count? Well, yeah, that's what the math-minded Maya did. Next time, we'll check out the Aztecs, who improved on several Olmec and Maya achievements on the way to building their own awesome civilization. But until then, historians, keep uncovering the past and looking to the future. And remember to always be clever. Hey, hey!